You have to find it as fast as you can. Just open the page, boom. And that's it. It's a time challenge. Is that a video?
Yes.
Where is Wally, guys? Where is Wally? I don't know. I'm trying to find him.
Welcome to Monitor. So this is basically where the band gets their in-ear mixes. And we've got one board here for the vocals and another one over there for band. And that's it. We push people's buttons.
Oh, were you guys filming?
Oh!
Bro!
I'm
bro.
So
sorry. Yeah, bro!
I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
Hi, this is our... This... Blah, blah, blah. When we put together an album like the one... So we're from the start. We need help. Hi, welcome to This Is Our Time Behind the Scenes. This is about our 10th take and I've written some notes. This is our time. This is the album that we put out for this season. And really what happens is the year prior to you even hearing any of those songs is we're developing them, we're writing them back home in our church, Planet Shakers, Melbourne.
How did we come up with the song selection for the album? You know, we sing so many songs in church in every year we probably teach 30 to 40 songs. So getting it down to the song list was a really big challenge. You know, Joth, Sam and I and a few others sat down and we went what we loved the best and worked it out. And it was really hard. A couple of them were so close, but it's pretty exciting. We love what God has given our songwriters for this album. The worship is absolutely incredible. And I believe that God will really bless people through it.
So really in an album, you're getting the best songs possible that can lead you and your church into the presence of God. Really, they're tried and tested. They're true. They're helping people encounter Jesus week in, week out.
Here we are at Planet Shakers Awakening. It's our first night. We're about to start our prayer meeting in the band room, and where God is going to move. It's going to be awesome. You can watch it.
Is that true? You won't feel me.
We haven't quite started yet.
Yeah. On the back.
And like a bit of a.
Oh no!
And then like a bit of a strain at the last bit. I did it with ease.
Get this on camera.
Okay, so leading up to conferences, I do this all the time. You know, you prepare, you go over the songs, you think about them, you sing them over and over. And, you know, this one particular day I was driving in my car and just thinking about what's going to happen at the conference and, you know, just imagining myself singing this particular song that Andy wrote called You. I got on my phone and I rang Joth and I started to tell him about, you know, this sort of vision I suppose I had or this desire that I had with this song. And so as we began to talk, I said, you know, I'd love to sing Holy and, you know, just have another moment coming out of this song, You. And so he's on the phone and so he just starts singing and says, yeah, what about something like, you know, Holy? And I'm like, yeah, that sounds good. And so we're really creating this thing on the phone, in the car. And then remembering a moment that we had previously with Natalie, and she sang a beautiful song one particular night at conference. And wouldn't it be great to have a moment like that again? And so, you know, talking about perhaps Natalie singing something, but also Chelsea, because, you know, they're beautiful worshippers. They have incredible voices. And, you know, just allowing them to sing and be part of this, I think would, you know, just take us to the next level. And so, you know, at rehearsal, we're working on things, and just slowly, bit by bit, you know, things were just coming together.
So prophetic moment, yep. But not spontaneous, it's going to write it. So we'll have this chord progression, the new part, which is like a tab. We'll be...
We sang this song, You, and it was the presence of God, and, you know, people just, their hearts were so open and loving God, and then we bring the song down and we start to sing Holy, and oh my goodness, what can I say apart from the fact that at that moment it turned into a very holy moment where people were just caught up in the presence of God, and such an incredible moment of worship. And then as the girls sang, and it did, it took us to another level. All of our dreams came true about that song. It was so powerful. We're so thankful.
Hard work you're putting in, especially for everyone who's filming in the afternoon. You know, you're putting in a lot of work. But I'm just really believing that as we get up on stage tonight, Holy Spirit's going to give us power and the anointing to do what we do.
Oh, ow, my ears tangled in my hair.
That's awesome.
Now I smell like a dude.
These are my shakers, planet shakers. Sorry.
Hey, I'm JD. I'm the operator of the tube camera. Woo! Basically, I just sit here and swing over people and get all the really cool, sweet shots over the crowds and over the band.
This is the side of stage here. Here we've got the band mics and packs. We have all their in-ears, all their microphones, and everything that they might need to take up on stage with them. We lay them out here for the band and singers to come and grab before they go up on stage, or sometimes not grab them and go up on stage.
Hey, come over here. I want to show you the production team's best kept secret. Looks like a normal road case, but in here is their kitchen. So we've got a little coffee maker. This is what keeps the production team running, all this coffee here. We've got a fridge here where you've got your milk, some drinks, water to keep it stocked. Here's the fuel for them, some lollies. And what's in here? Oh, look at that, more coffee pots. Yeah, so that's what's keeping the production team going during the day.
Dude, okay. What are you doing? What are you doing? Wait.
Sorry, we can't be showing. Sorry.
Hey guys, here we are. We'll clap first. Hey guys, here we are in the studio working on the new album. This album is phenomenal. It's going to be our best yet. We always say that every year, but it's actually the truth. We always do better and better. But I was just singing a new song to the Lord. That's what we like to do. We like to sing new songs. We like to produce new songs, produce fresh sounds, creative sounds, sounds that will inspire the world to worship. And so, you know, there's a lot of different steps to producing the album. The first step that we do is choose the takes of the album. So after conference is finished, I'll come back in here and have a listen through every song from every session and hear what we recorded. So the conference is 3 days and four nights, so we record absolutely everything. Once those decisions have been made and we have our take list, then we'll come in here and start to edit and do some overdubs. Now, we know that this album says it's a live album, but it's not entirely live. I hate to break it to you. We need to come in and do some overdubs. And the reason for that is because on stage, we are so energetic. You know, we're jumping around, going crazy, and it is hard to sometimes keep the control, especially when you're singing, when you're jumping up and down heaps. So more than just replacing everything, we come in and add to what's already there just to strengthen the vocals. I'll make sure the drums are nice and tight. Because we use a lot of tracks live, we want the drums to really lock in with the tracks, especially for these dance praise songs. In this song, like we keep all the live vocals, and so this is what all the vocals sound like from conference. These are all the live vocals.
And now, this will be the best time of our life as we encounter your love again. Here with you, our heart.
And now, as a group, they sound really good, and so that's why we keep them, and they're quite loud in the mix as well. Which so the mix sounds like this. So they blend in quite well. But if you go into each individual person, then you can actually hear that maybe it's not so good. You know, people forgetting words sometimes, people losing breath. So let's have a look here at Joe, our singer with swag. The first line of this.
From the start, to collide with the light.
So he sings the first word, and then he decides he doesn't want to sing the second and third word, but then he comes back in for the fourth and fifth word.
From the start, to collide with the lust.
And I think he does it here as well.
Set apart.
So he comes in a bit late. And so, you know, if we didn't overdub that, you'd hear these little dips. And then you've got the issue of, you know, you're wanting to sing the wrong right words, which, you know, let's have a look here at BJ.
This is...
I actually don't know what he's saying there.
This is set apart.
Can you hear that?
This is set apart.
This is set apart. And yeah, so that's my, maybe he's singing in tongues, I don't know. But, you know, that is just the reasons why we do it. When you're in the moment and it's live and you're praising and you're worshipping and you don't care, you just want to praise God, sometimes we do forget our words. But the important is the heart, and BJ had a great heart then. Even though he was singing gibberish, he was singing it into the Lord, and that's important. And so, but that's the reason why we do vocal overdubs, just to strengthen that. But like I said, as a group, they still sound great, and you don't notice these things.
Every heart set apart just to be where you are.
Once that's done, we start mixing, which is what I'm doing right now. As you can see behind me, I've got a session open. This is covered, which sounds... It's coming out really good. And then so basically I'm mixing that, so I've got every individual channel. So I'll show you, I've got the drums here. That's just the drums. That's the crowd. There's our electric guitars. Acoustic guitars. We have our piano. We have some strings. It's like a keyboard line. And then after it's mixed, then it goes to what we call mastering. And mastering is where they take each song and just basically bring the level up and make it sound even better than the mix. And so from there, then we put it onto a CD or upload it to iTunes, and then you can purchase it. So that's the process.